Hey everybody, so I'm coming today with this look that you see here. This is my interpretation of Bombshell makeup. If you want to see how I got this look, then just go ahead and keep on watching. Okay, so I'm going to start by taking Max Paint and Bare Canvas. And I'm going to take a little bit of that and apply that to my whole eyelid area and my lower lash line. Okay, and right over that, I'm going to take this corrector in the color Light. And I'm going to apply that just to my eyelid area. Okay, and today I'm going to be using the Closest Lens 28 Neutral Palette. And the first two colors I'm going to be going in with are, let me point with this. It's this pink one, and I'm going to mix it with this one here. So I'm going to take a mixture of both of those right there. And I'm going to be taking that on my e.l.f. eyeshadow C brush, which looks like this. And applying that to my lid. Okay, the next color I'm going to be taking is this one, which is all the way at the top. And it's kind of like a little duochrome color. And I'm going to be going in with my Real Techniques Base Shadow Brush. I'm going to pick that up and I'm going to apply that to the crease and a little bit above my brow bone. Okay, and for blending's sake, I'm going to be going in with this color right here. And this kind of flat top angled brush from Coastal Scent. And I'm going to be taking that right above the color we added previously. And I'm going to, this basically what this color is going to do is help us blend the darker color a little bit better. Okay, now I'm going to be taking this color right here. And I'm going to be using that as my highlight with a very large eyeshadow brush. Again from Coastal Scents. Excuse the screaming, it's my daughter. Okay, and now to really make this look really intense, I'm going to be going in with this black eyeshadow right here. And I'm going to be taking a MAC 22, I don't know, it's a large a tapered blending brush. And applying that directly to my crease where I want to add the most intensity. Okay, now for the lower lash line, I'm going in with this first color that we added and the black color that's down here. And I'm going to mix those two and add them to the lower lash line. I see you, Delilah. That's my baby. Okay, so I've taken a little pointed Q-tip and applied a makeup remover. And I'm just going to roll it like so to remove all this extra fallout. Okay, now I'm going to be going in with my NYC liquid eyeliner and making a very small cat eye right here. Okay, so now I'm going to be taking my red cherry eyelash in 747S, which stands for short. With my dual eyelash adhesive in black, I'm going to put on my eyelash and be right back. I'm going to set those in with my CoverGirl Lash Blast mascara, just to make sure that I intertwine them. Okay, now I'm going to be going in with MAC's Black Track Fluid Line and their 212 brush. I'm going to take my product and apply this gel liner to my waterline. Okay, and you know we can't be no bombshells with some uneven skin. So I'm going to be taking my MAC Studio Fix Fluid in NC, in the shade NC30. And I'm going to squirt that onto the back of my hand. I did two pumps. Now I'm going to take my new Sigma, what is it? It's a F80 brush, and it's a flat top kabuki brush. This is the first time I'm using this product. So we'll see. So I'm going to spray it with my MAC Fix Plus. I did three sprays. And I'm going to work the product. I'm going to work it into the product, as I regularly do with my other brushes. And I'm going to stipple it on. Oh my god. And I like to work from inward outward. Oh my god, I really love this brush. Look at how quickly it covered the redness in my cheeks. Okay, now I'm going to apply concealer, and I'm going to be using my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, also in the shade NC30. And same thing with this, a little bit goes a very long way. And I put it again on the back of my hand. And I'm going to take that with my finger and apply it like this to put it where I want. And with this, even though this is in an NC30, since it is different formulation, it seems to be very lighter than my NC30 in the Studio Fix fluid. Okay, now I'm going to go back in with this same awesome F80, and I'm going to buff that into my under eyes. Look at how quickly that spreads it out. I usually use my Sonia Kashuk. It's like a pointed dome brush. And usually with that I have to do, you know, even though it is pointed, I see no difference between this one and that one. Except this one actually blends it out a lot quicker. If you guys are interested in, you know, getting, you know, Sigma, this one is from the Sigmax collection, which means that they are synthetic, so they don't have any real animal hair. So if you guys want to check, you know, Sigma brushes out, I'll go ahead and put the link in the bottom bar. You know what? This is the first Sigma brush I try, and quite honestly, it's taking away from my tutorial because I'm, like, amazed with it. I really love it. Okay, now I'm going to go in with my Hard Candy Welcome Matte Powder. It's just a matte powder. Look at how much I use that. I love this powder. Okay, and I'm going to go in with the Sonia Kashuk pointed foundation brush. And I'm going to use that to set my concealer. Okay, now for the cheeks, I'm going to go in with MAC's Ripe Peach Blush Ombre and their 168 brush, and apply that to the apples of my cheeks to give myself a little color. I'm going to be taking my favorite bronzer, and that is MAC Pink Power Mineralized Skin Finish. And I'm just going to be taking this middle dark color right here with my MAC 109 and applying that into the hollows of my cheeks. Okay, now for my highlight, I'm going to be taking this Mineralized Skin Finish, which is a MSF powder and a, it's a shimmer, that's just what it says. I don't think they sell these anymore, but I'm just going to be using the top part with this fan brush from e.l.f. And I'm going to give myself the little Bombshell Glow. So you just take your whatever highlight you have and you want to put it to the highest point of your face and work the product in. What I like to do is go take the product into a C shape, like so. As you can see, it goes like this. It's kind of like that little J-Lo glow. Okay, and last but not least, for our lips, I'm going to be going in with MAC's Pink Plaid Lipstick. It's a pretty cool tone pink. I'm going to take that straight from the tube. You can totally do like red lips, nude lips. I'm going to go with this pink lipstick, which is pretty close. As naturally close as you can get to my real lip color. And I'm going to be going in with MAC's Liqueur in Tongue in Cheek. If you guys can see that. So this, what it does is kind of pearlizes. Let me get closer. Maybe you can see it or not. It kind of pearlizes the lipstick. Maybe you'll be able to see it in the picture. And that is it. This is your completed look. It's fairly simple. Nothing too extraordinary. You know, impossible to do. So if you like this look, go ahead and give it a try. I hope I, you know, spoke as clearly as I possibly could. And well, yeah, thank you guys for watching. Thanks to all my new subscribers. If you haven't already, go ahead and enter my little lipstick mech contest, which I'm going on, which I will also link in the bottom bar. And also thank you to Vinci from Sigma for sending me this brush. I swear I really love it. And I'm not just saying that, this was my honest opinion. You guys saw me use it for the first time on camera. So thank you, Vinci, for sending me that. If you guys are interested in purchasing Sigma brushes, I'll go ahead and also link those in the bottom bar. As far as I know, if you purchase over $30 on their website, they send you a free gift. So, I mean, free makeup is free makeup. So yeah, if you guys want to check them out, like I said, I'll put the link in the bottom bar. And thank you guys for watching. Till next time and my next video. Bye.